Welcome to Shanti Peaceful Mathematics. In my previous video, you have learned about what is polar form of a complex number. That means, we have learned that any complex number z equal to x plus iy can be represented as z is equal to r into cos theta plus I sin theta. These things we have learned in our previous video. Today we are going to discuss about what is the exponential form of a complex number. The symbol e raised to I theta or exp of I theta is defined as e raised to I theta equal to cos theta plus I sin theta. This identity is known as Euler's formula. So Euler was a Swiss mathematician and his full name is Leonhard Euler. In 18th century, he has developed this formula and gives very important result. This is in mathematics. We can say that there is, in particular, theta is any value it will take, any real number it will have. So, in particular, if I take theta is equal to pi, then this will be e raised to I pi equal to cos pi plus I sin pi, and that will give you minus 1 because cos pi will be minus 1 and sin pi will be 0. So this formula e raised to I pi equal to minus 1, it's known as Euler's identity. And this identity is actually very beautiful result. In mathematics, it says that the most beautiful result. Because why? E raised to I pi plus 1 equal to 0. So this equation contains 5 constants. So the first one is the 0, which is the identity for real number, complex number, additive identity for real number and complex number, all sort of things. The another number is 1, which is the multiplicative identity for complex number, real number, all sort of things. The third is exponential function, that is the e, that is natural logarithm. The next number is 5, which is the irrational number, and also there is a fifth constant will be I, which is a complex number. So actually this equation is contains the 5 constants and all of them gives you this beautiful equation. Now as we have discussed in my previous video that any complex number z can be represented as r into cos theta plus I sin theta. So now this cos theta plus I sin theta we have expressed as the exponential function, that is the r e raised to I theta due to the exponential identity or Euler's formula we have this. So any complex number it can be written in the exponential form as z equal to e raised to I theta. This is known as the exponential form of a complex number. Now let's go further, consider the two identity or two Euler formula e raised to I theta 1 equal to cos theta 1 plus I sin theta 1 and e raised to I theta 2 will be cos theta 2 plus I sin theta 2. So now if I multiply these two identities, what we can have is e raised to I theta 1 into e raised to I theta 2 will gives you cos, see this cos theta 1 will multiply to this cos theta 2. So that will be cos theta 1 into cos theta 2 and I square, because this I sin theta 1 will multiply to I sin theta 1, that will gives you I square and that will gives you. So what we'll have is I square, so it will give you cos theta 1 into cos theta 2 minus sin theta 1 into sin theta 2 plus I. This cos theta 1 will multiply here I sine theta 2 will multiply to I sine theta 2, so that will be cos theta 1 into sine theta 2, plus this I sine theta 1 will multiply to cos theta 2, so that will give you cos theta 2 sine theta 1. I will common out from that here. So that will be gives you this quantity is cos theta 1 plus theta 2 plus I sine theta 1 plus theta 2. That is using the formula of cos alpha plus beta that we can have. And that we can write as e raised to I theta 1 plus theta 2. So that means we have the e raised to I theta 1 plus theta 2 will gives you e raised to I theta 1 into e raised to I theta 2. So it is exactly the same formula that we have derived in our previous video. Have some remarks here. The first one, if I take theta 1 is equal to theta and theta 2 equal to minus theta in 1, this is my equation 1 if I consider, then what we'll have e raised to I theta minus theta will have, because theta 1 we have taken as theta and theta 2 is minus theta, so that's why it is equal to minus theta equal to e raised to I theta into e raised to minus I theta will have. So that will gives you e raised to 0, and that is 1 equal to e raised to I theta into e raised to minus I theta. So therefore we'll have e raised to minus I theta will be 1 upon e raised to I theta. So e raised to minus I theta can be expressed as 1 upon e raised to minus I. The second remark that we have, if I take theta 1 equal to theta 2 equal to theta in 1, we have e raised to I theta 1, that is theta plus theta, equal to e raised to I theta into e raised to I theta. So that will gives you e raised to 2 theta will gives you e raised to I theta square. And if you extend this result using PMI, we can say that e raised to I theta raised to n will be e raised to I n theta for any n belongs to n. So this identity is also known as the De Morgan's theorem, and which says that cos theta plus I sine theta power n is equal to cos n theta plus I sine theta. And the proof of this identity we'll see in the next video. That is, the next video is about the De Morgan's theorem and its application. So we'll see the proof of this result and also the its application to find out certain things. Third remark that we can write down now is conjugate of exponential, that we can write as cos theta plus I sine theta conjugate. So that will be gives you cos theta minus I sine theta, and this will gives you cos of minus theta plus I sine of minus theta, because cos of minus theta will be cos theta because cos is even function, and sine of minus theta is minus sine theta because sine is an odd function. So that's why this will be right as e raised to minus I theta. So therefore what we have is e raised to conjugate of this exponential e raised to I theta will be e raised to minus I theta. And due to this, if z is equal to r e raised to I theta, then z bar we can write as e raised to minus I theta. The fourth quantity that we can write is what will be the multiplicative inverse due to that. So if you have z is equal to r e raised to I theta, then 1 upon z or z inverse will be 1 upon r e raised to minus I. That is easily checked by some calculation. That is 1 upon z you can write as 1 upon r e raised to I theta, so that we can write as 1 upon r into cos theta plus I sine theta, and if you multiply and divide by cos theta minus I sine theta, what we'll get is 1 upon r cos theta minus I sin theta upon cos square theta plus sin square theta, and that will be 1. So that will gives you 1 upon r cos theta minus I sin theta, and that will give you 1 upon r e minus I. The fifth remark that we have, if two complex numbers are equal, that means if z1 equal to r1 e raised to I theta 1 and z2 equal to r2 e raised to I theta 2, if you want to say z1 is equal to z2 if and only if the r1 is same as r2, that means at radius vectors are same and also their argument or amplitude have the difference with 2 and pi. So for any n belongs to that, this will be that. So theta 1 is equal to theta 2 plus 2 and pi, that is the difference of their amplitude or argument is 2 and pi. So that is the fifth remark you have. The sixth remark that we can write is, if you have the any complex number z equal to r e raised to I theta, that can be also write as r e raised to I theta plus 2 and pi, because in previous videos also we have seen. Now what is the seventh remark that I want to mention here? The geometrically, what is the meaning of this angle of theta indicates the theta is actually interpreted as the angle of indication, the radius vector of the length r representing the number z equal to r e raised to I theta. That z is lies on the circle of radius r center at origin. If you consider this is your y axis and this is your x axis, and if your point, this radius of this circle will be r, then this the point is z equal to r e raised to I theta. So what is this represent is indicate the circle of the radius r, z is always lies on this circle. And if you change the value of theta, it will rotate. Suppose the theta will be pi by 2 will be here. So that is the z1, if I can write r e raised to I theta plus pi by 2, if this angle is 90 degrees. So that's theta, this is the angle theta, and this is theta plus pi by 2. So any number z is equal to r e raised to I theta is always lies on the circle with radius r. So if you increase the value of theta, the point is move along the circle and in the counterclockwise direction. And in particular, if you increase the theta by, so the theta plus 2 pi, that means if you have here and if you make one round of this circle, and that will come again to the same point. And if you decrease the value by 2 pi, then you have to go into the clockwise direction and you will come into the again. So if you have a theta minus 2 pi, that will be also a same point. So that is the geometrically this points or this r and theta is represented. So according to this, what will be the modulus of z is r that we can have. So if I consider a fixed radius r of circle, then z can be represented as r e raised to I theta, where theta is any value between 0 to 2. So what is this? It is actually the equation of a circle with center at origin and radius is capital R. So any circle with the center at origin and radius r will be represented by this equation r is equal to e raised to I theta. Rotation in the counterclockwise direction, so is a positive direction. Now if I have the circle, so if you have x axis and y axis, if I consider this is your x axis and this will be your y axis, and if you have a circle here which center is not an origin, so center if I consider as a z0, then this radius or this vector, that is your z0 vector. So if I consider any point on this circle as a z, so this vector that will have a z, and so what will be this vector? It is a z minus z0, and this radius vector is fixed, so that is a z minus z0 is equal to capital R. If you have, then we can say that it is this, for any z it will represent the points on the circle. Now due to this, we can write z minus z0 is equal to R e raised to I theta, where theta is takes any value between 0 to 2 pi. So any equation of the circle having the center at z0 and radius is R, we can write as this formula. So center at z0 and radius R of circle in the positive direction or positive orientation, if you can consider on this orientation, if you consider, then parametric representation of the circle will be represented in this way. So that's it for today's lecture. So let us recall what we have did. We have defined first thing as exponential form, that is e raised to I theta equal to cos theta plus I sine theta. This identity is also very beautiful because it's involved the exponential function, the trigonometric functions. That we have talked about the most beautiful equation, that is e raised to pi is equal to minus 1, which contains pi constant, as if you represent that as e raised to pi plus 1 equal to 0. Next, we have talked about some properties of if you represent your z as r e raised to I theta in that form, that we can have inverse option, we have a conjugate of the number. If you have the product of two number, then you have a formula for that. We have discussed about what is the equation of the circle if it is a radius r and the center is 0. And also, if the two numbers, two complex numbers are equal, then the radius vector are same, as well as the amplitude, the difference of amplitude or argument is having 2 and pi. So thank you very much for listening me. Please like, subscribe to YouTube channel. If you have any questions, kindly write down on the comment box. And the lecture notes of this is also given in the description. So please have a look on the description. Thank you. Sayonara. Bye-bye.